culture, we're not given the opportunity to cultivate creativity, which I think is a detriment to the success of who we are as humans, as schools, as educators, as businesses, understanding the steps to creative process and what makes you tick, what makes you fly, what makes your ideas. How many of you think that you're creative? How do you come up with decision from point A to point B to the completed project? And you start gathering. But this stage, I think, is one of the most important parts of the creative process. And then all of a sudden, you're driving down the road, and boom, you're like, oh, that's... How many of you have had, like, that aha moment? What is that like? Why didn't I think about that before? And why? You've got that idea. Stage three, done. It's ready. Now I'm going to churn it out. And you start working on location. It's the last stage of an idea or expose it outside of your head. Because you think it's awesome, right? You think it's the best thing you've ever done. That response lets you know whether that idea is going to fly or not. Make a decision. There's actually a very methodical process that's going on. The unknown is not familiar and it's not comfortable. Okay, I'm going to explore. There's beauty in that because you're using that fear as something to generate energy towards success. What do you see? It's triggering your creativity. It's allowing you to see things differently. When you change that aperture, you're taking in all this information. Look at this scary unknown as a possibility. Where do you start? Focus out. Focus in. Pay attention to those details and be inspired new ways to look at your life. Because when you change the way you look at things, the things you look at change.